Hello. Let me show you how to extract web data using Python's AutoScraper library. You'll learn how to extract URLs, product titles and prices, and how to use proxies to facilitate the whole process. Also, to automate the following script or any script you may have at preferred intervals, check our video on scheduling, link in the top right. With that said, let's get started. AutoScraper is a web scraping library known for being lightweight and easy to use, a good fit for beginners. AutoScraper accepts URLs and HTMLs of any website. From there, it takes the sample data you want to scrape. It learns the scraping rules and then reapplies them for subsequent target pages to extract similar content. Now let's install AutoScraper. There are several ways to install and use the library. This time, let's use the Python package index repository. Run this PAP command. For the scraping target, let's use Oxylabs Scraping Sandbox, a mock marketplace with 3,000 products in different categories. To scrape the links to the category pages, use this code. Note that the Oxylabs Sandbox uses JavaScript to load some elements dynamically, such as the category buttons. Since AutoScraper doesn't support JavaScript rendering, you won't be able to scrape all the category links. For instance, you can access the Xbox platform category, but not the subcategories inside. The code first imports AutoScraper from the AutoScraper library. Then I provide the URL from which to scrape data in the URL to scrape. The wanted list assigns sample data you want to scrape from the given subject URL. To get the category page links from the target page, you need to provide two example URLs to the wanted list. One link is a data sample of a JavaScript rendered category button, while the other is a data sample of a static category button with no subcategories. Try running the code with only one category URL in the wanted list to see the difference. The AutoScraper constructor creates an AutoScraper object to initiate different actions of the AutoScraper library. The scraper build method scrapes data similar to the wanted list from the target URL. After executing the script, the data list will have the category page links available at sandbox.oxylabs.io/products. The output of the script should look like this. If you need to render dynamic content, you could integrate AutoScraper with a lightweight module like Splash or use heavy-duty libraries such as Selenium, Playwright, Puppeteer, and many others. For Scrapy Splash tutorial, see link on the top right. So far, I've shown how to extract URLs from a web page. So let's see how to scrape the actual page content such as product titles and prices. To do so, you can train and build an AutoScraper model. This script feeds a URL to a product page and a sample of target data to the AutoScraper model. The build method learns the rules for scraping information and preparing InfoScraper for future use. Now, let's apply the InfoScraper tactics to a different product URL and see if it returns the desired data. The output confirms that it indeed works as expected. The script applies InfoScraper to another product URL and prints data. Depending on the target website, you may want to use the getResultsExact function instead of getSetResultsSimilar. This should ensure that AutoScraper returns accurate product titles and prices as defined by the wanted list. Additionally, it's very important to provide a URL to scrape that doesn't have duplicate data, which could match some unwanted elements. Take a look at this example. Here the URL to scrape has the price of $91.99 on the page twice. The code also matches the unwanted element with the same price and additionally returns the price of a related product. One way to solve this problem is to use the grouped true parameter to return the data points with their corresponding AutoScraper rule names. Use the keep rules function and pass the rules you want to keep. In this code, you have to turn the data dictionary into a list to access and pass over the first and the last rule containing accurate product title and price. Do note that this method may return incorrect results if the actual product price isn't the last item returned by the data object. Until now, I showed you how to extract similar and exact information from a specific web page, including URLs. Let's see how to scrape data from all product pages in a specific category. To do so, use two scrapers. One for scraping URLs of all the products in a category and the other to scrape information from each link. Install the pandas and open PyExcel libraries via the terminal. These libraries will be used to save data to an Excel file. Now let's see the script. It has three main constituents. Two sections for building scrapers and the third to scrape data from all products in the PlayStation 5 category and save it to an Excel file. For this step, I have already built product URL scraper to scrape all the similar product links on the PlayStation 5 category page. The 13 links are stored in the product's URL list. Now for each URL in the product's URL list, apply the product info scraper and append the scraped information to the product's info list. Lastly, the product's info list is converted to a data frame and then exported as an Excel file for future use. Here is the output. It achieves the initial goal, scraping titles and prices of all products in the PlayStation 5 category. You can use a combination of multiple AutoScraper modules to scrape data in bulk. You can reformulate the script to scrape all products from all the categories and save them in different Excel files representing each category. Now let's see how to use proxies with AutoScraper. The doubt proxies acquiring web data in bulk involves risks such as the target website blocking your IP address. Let's prevent this scenario before it happens. The build, get result similar, and get result exact functions of AutoScraper accept request related arguments in the request args parameter. visits ip.oxylabs.io, copy the displayed IP address, and paste it into the wanted list. This information will be used to tell AutoScraper what kind of data to look for. The proxy endpoint refers to the address of a proxy server in the correct format. The script should work fine when proper proxy endpoints are added to the proxy dictionary. Every time you run the code, it outputs a proxy IP address that should be different from your actual IP. After successfully testing the proxy connection, you can use the proxy with the initial request. AutoScraper provides the ability to save and load a pre-trained scraper. Use this script to save the InfoScraper object to a file. Similarly, you can load a scraper using these slides. If you have any questions about Python web scraping, comment below, email support@oxylabs.io, or write us via the live chat on our webpage. Also consider joining our Discord community. And always remember that you can try all of our scraper APIs for free to greatly simplify the process shown in this video. Thanks for watching.